This is the sound of a generation rising up. This is the sound of a generation rising.
One of the things that we believe God has called us to is to be a place of development. Now, when you say development, some of the times people don't really know what you're talking about. And we've had people ask us, you know, what is development? You know, I know what a house of prayer is, I know what a house of worship is. What is a place of development? We could have said discipleship. And the problem with that, though, is that everybody would think that they knew what we meant, and they would probably be wrong. People have an idea of what discipleship is and what it looks like. And a lot of times what they're thinking is, you know, sitting at a table and reading a Bible together, or sitting at a table and going through a checklist of, you know, all these things, had my quiet time today and did this and that. And that's really not what we think of when we talk about discipleship. When we say house of development or a place of development, we're really talking about investing in people's lives. We believe, as the Bible says, that God's desire is that all of us would be brought to a place of maturity in Him, so that we can have maximum impact in the world that we live in.
To me, one of the biggest questions you want to ask the church is, what are you believing God for? Because if we're not believing God for anything, then we are not living out our faith. And I think the difference between a church that is hardened and sees no life and a church that's full of life and grace is faith. And here at Riverstone, one of the things we want to do is create opportunities where our people gather together to believe together, in prayer. And of course, prayer is the way we express that faith for what we're believing God for. So each month, we provide opportunity to gather together and pray together and to believe together for God to break in with His power, with His grace, and with His presence to make a difference in our church.
Make us ready. Make us ready.
We do that at Face Down every month. And then periodically we have prayer initiatives where we gather the people together to pray. And I've always been amazed at the response of the people. They come. They don't just come, but our people pray, they worship, they engage, they believe. And I'm convinced that it's this believing together that is moving us toward the vision of seeing full community transformation. So prayer's at the heart of our church. Believing's at the heart of our church. And we want to create the opportunities where we, as a people, gather together, worship, and trust God in prayer to see the breakthroughs that we need.
I think one of the big turning points for us was when we realized that community transformation was not our idea, something that we were trying to talk God into, but it was actually something that was in His heart that He was trying to talk us into. When we think about community transformation and really try to put, you know, legs on it, we see it just as the presence of God changing an area completely. We believe that we will see tangible evidence that God is changing our community, things that can be measured. We're looking at things like the crime rate dropping, abortion disappearing, the divorce rate diminishing. And we believe that if God can do that in a small place, He can do it in a large place.
There's darkness in my skin. My covers wearing thin. I believe I'd love to start again.
And even to the point of people coming into the community from the outside and being able to sense a difference in the atmosphere. know, I think we've all walked into places before where God is moving and you could just sense it. You could feel the presence of God tangibly in a place. And so we expect that there will be times in the future where people will drive into our region, into our county. Maybe they're traveling, just passing through, but they will tangibly be able to sense God's presence here in a different way, in a stronger way than they did before.
Riverstone worship is a massive ingredient of who we are, and I think people, you know, when they think worship, they automatically think about music and sonic, you know, sonic sound, and that's a huge part of who we are. But really, I mean, our dream is that we want to create an atmosphere of worship, and an atmosphere where miracles can take place. And even before people enter into singing, you know, before people even get to the sanctuary, as people are pulling to the parking lots and parking, we want to fill this whole campus full of God's presence. And all of a sudden, people are feeling this tangible presence of something's happening, something's going on. So by the time they get to the singing part, their hearts are ready to go. And then all of a sudden, we just start to see God just move, and miracles begin to take place.
Today, a healing ministry has become central to the vision of Riverstone Church. It's one of the primary ways that we see God using our church to bring transformation to our community. Currently, we have over 200 people who are involved in our prayer and healing ministries here at Riverstone. Those ministries include our Nights of Healing Prayer, our Sozo Ministry, which is an inner healing ministry, and also our altar ministry on Sunday morning, where we always end our services with an opportunity for people to receive prayer. In the book of Mark, there's a verse that says that believers will actually lay their hands on the sick and they will recover. It's a profound mystery, but a wonderful reality. And here at Riverstone, we just want to invite you to join us in this healing ministry as we learn to partner with God in bringing healing not only to our community, but also to our world.
We know that God has called us to be a people of outreach. It's clear all through Scripture that this is His heart. Acts 1:8 says, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." And it's clear all through the Bible that God's heart is for us to go on the offense, to take His presence, to take the good news of Jesus outside of the four walls of the church, into the grocery store, into the gas stations, into restaurants. God's heart is for this to be our DNA. So it's not just about an event or an activity or a little side ministry, but it's for Riverstone to become a people of outreach.